During the 19th century, the concept of thermodynamics was revolutionized around the world. The study of energy and its behavior had gained public notability, and with it, it brought new curious ideas about our universe. One of them was the concept that the universe that we know of has existed for a finite amount of time. This hypothesis was initially derived from the idea of entropy and the second law of thermodynamics, how, over time, a closed system gets more disordered. Because of this fact, if our universe were to have existed for trillions of years, the temperature inside it, according to the second law, would roughly be the same everywhere. Considering that the universe is also expanding, astronomers have been able to analyze old stars and calculate how astronomical bodies are moving to eventually determine, by our current theories, that the universe is over 13 billion years old. There are billions of galaxies and sextillions of stars out there. Not only that, but solar systems of vastly different sizes can be found everywhere. So, there is bound to be extraterrestrial life not distant away from us. Yet, since the history of humankind, there have been zero signs of life within the depths of space. Where is extraterrestrial life? The exact same question was posed by the scientist Enrico Fermi in the 1950s during a casual lunch conversation at Los Alamos. His reason behind the question is that any civilization with modest rocket technology would be able to conquer large parts of space, and considering that the solar system we live in is very young compared to the universe, there is bound to be intelligent civilizations out there with much more advanced technology than us. However, what is strange is that there have been no signs of them whatsoever. Thus, this problem quickly became an inexplicable paradox, a question that even modern scientists today are trying to find an answer to. This leads to the only explanation being that alien and extraterrestrial life is absent within our observable universe. In an unpublished manuscript made in 1933, before the paradox even came to fruition, the Russian physicist Konstantin Tsiolkovsky noted two reasons for why people deny the existence of external life. If such beings exist, they would have visited Earth, and, if such civilizations existed, then they would have given us some signs of their existence. Nevertheless, there are several people who deny this conclusion, instead making counterarguments to why extraterrestrial life is highly probable and why Fermi's paradox is not a paradox at all. That it is to be expected. An article written by Robert H. Gray states that Enrico Fermi never actually said that intelligent extraterrestrial life is non-existent and that the absence of it is paradoxical. It is further stated that this is due to a mix-up from an argument about the Fermi paradox by astrophysicist Michael Hart. In other words, the argument that life in outer space is absent originated from a theory posed by another scientist, and never by Enrico Fermi himself. In fact, there is only one known instance in where Fermi mentions this idea, with it being only one short quote, "Where is everybody?" However one might interpret this, it still does not fully answer the question of why we have not been able to confirm the existence of other civilizations. But of course, there has been no shortage of theories. This is the Drake equation. It was a formula created by scientist Frank Drake in 1961 that had a goal to find a rough estimate of the total number of intelligent and detectable civilizations in the Milky Way galaxy. It has seven different factors which together approximate the number of notable extraterrestrial civilizations in our galaxy. By plugging and crunching in the established numbers, the Drake equation states that the lower bound of how many of said civilizations exist within the Milky Way is roughly 20, with the maximum being close to 50 million. These results may seem counterintuitive, as, if there were millions of similar civilizations to us humanity, we would expect to gain at least some notable indications of their existence. However, one must take into account that the values assigned to the variables are very uncertain. There are many pieces of information which lack clarity due to the overall scarcity of data. We cannot, by certainty, confirm the accuracy of values that have been used in the equation. In addition, as put by Frank Drake himself, this formula serves as a probabilistic argument and shall only be seen as a starting point for further research of extraterrestrial life. Considering the Drake equation, we can question what the probability is that there exist sophisticated civilizations within our galaxy. The argument goes that there is actually an abundant amount of biological life in outer space, but none of them are advanced enough to be able to convey or receive signals from us. This relates to something called the Great Filter, which can be visualized as a barrier which prevents civilizations from advancing to a certain stage. It is predicted that a majority of life will never advance far enough to reach beyond the Great Filter due to natural causes such as mass extinctions and evolutionary difficulties. This could be a likely explanation for the Fermi Paradox, as since the late 20th century we have found several planets capable of sustaining life, but none of them showing signs of having any intelligent species. Which begs the question of how rare it actually is to have extraterrestrial organisms capable of rivaling the intellect of humankind, which many argue is negligible. Several scientists even theorize that we, humanity, are one of the few who have made it past the Great Filter. Additionally, the same can be said, but the opposite. Maybe alien civilizations are so much more advanced compared to humanity that they simply do not care to visit or contact us. Maybe it is the case that the human civilization is nothing but an insignificant speckle within the copious magnitude of life within the universe. But, nonetheless, there have been many bewildering recorded instances of radio frequencies that have indicated otherwise. What you are hearing right now was a radio signal received by the Big Ear Radio Telescope on August 15, 1977. This particular frequency that was received that day is dubbed the WOW signal, and is, even to this day, one of the leading signs of the existence of extraterrestrial life. It lasted a full 72 seconds and is theorized to have originated in the direction of the constellation of Sagittarius centered between two stars. This would indicate that the radio signal that was received was at least 25,000 years old. Scientists have, in 2012, sent out a powerful radio transmission towards the calibrated direction, but in case if this really is external life, then we have to wait for at least 50,000 years before we get a response. What is particularly interesting about this radio emission is that its frequency calculated by Professor John Krause is roughly at 1420 MHz, which under certain circumstances is the frequency at which hydrogen emits. Coincidentally, hydrogen is also the most abundant element present within the universe, a piece of information that, theoretically, almost all advanced civilizations would know of. Additionally, it has been further ruled out that the radio signal was caused by a malfunction of the radio antenna or transmitted by a public satellite on Earth's orbit, indicating that this signal most likely came somewhere from outer space. In addition, the WOW signal was also narrowband, meaning that the frequencies that it occupied were narrow, thus implying that it did not leak into other radio frequencies, something which a majority of cosmic phenomena often emits under very specific circumstances. However, those natural phenomena that do cause narrowband signals are dissimilar from what was received by the Big Ear Radio Telescope on August 15, 1977. But whether or not it was coincidentally caused by a natural phenomenon or if it was an actual transmission by aliens to reach out to further civilizations is unclear. Astronomers have tried to search for the very same radio transmission. However, even after hundreds or possibly thousands of attempts within the last 45 years, no one has been able to detect something quite as similar as the WOW signal, leaving it as one of the big mysteries which may or may not show that aliens exist. Whether or not aliens exist, and why extraterrestrial civilizations are incredibly difficult to find is a question that either will be answered in the coming millennials or possibly never. But there is one thing to be certain about, whether we are alone or not, both are equally terrifying.